Everyone liked your father. He was a quiet sort of fellow, and he always had the very best of manners. And he was very concerned about appearance. He got concerned about my collars at one stage. He said, look, the best way on this is wear starched collars.
My father, Peter, was a modernist architect in New Zealand from the 1950s to the 1970s. I actually started this doco over 20 years ago. I just couldn't get an angle. There's hardly anything written. There's no video. There's a half a dozen photos.
Auckland University after the war is where it all happened. Vernon Brown was the boss, and this is where the two cliques emerged.
There's an established lineage in architectural history that we all think is gospel. So the modernists are Vernon Brown as father of the group, and then the group, and then the group splitting up, and that's architectural history in New Zealand in a nutshell. And it leaves out so many people and so many other avenues.
So now, what is the legacy of this argument about internationalism and regionalism in New Zealand?
The internationalists, they felt that modernism should go in one direction. The regionalists felt it should go in the other.
Around this time, something made Dad change his name from Brown to Mark Brown. We were always told it was not to be confused with Vernon Brown. I wanted to find out once and for all if that was true, and also learn more about Dad's main influence, Californian modernist, architect Richard Neutra.
When you glance at those works, do you see an obvious Neutra influence?
Yeah, in some more than others.
There's something similar about the way they sit in the landscape.
Absolutely, yeah. Just as my father adopted some things from Wright, but not others. Your father clearly is in that lineage.
Mark Brown Fairhead were some of the best known internationally oriented architects. And so we're doing lots of very, very beautiful, kind of crisp commercial buildings, houses.
They were interested in a sophisticated post-war world. Whereas Vernon Brown and the group were to an extent interested in a rustic post-war world.
The internationalists probably haven't been given as much attention as the regionalists still.
I just really wish that somebody who's done the glass-walled pavilion off the coast of Matakana wasn't saying Neutra, 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 but were saying Mark Brown Fairhead. The irony is, the New Zealand that we live in is the world that Mark Brown Fairhead were kind of looking for. It was a global experience.